It's a max level fire dragon wyvern. Oh shit! I'm dead! Hey guys, new episode. Sorry I didn't put one up yesterday. Yesterday. But I was doing a shit ton of preparation, as you can see here. Got my Argent, and I've leveled it up quite a bit. Actually a lot. Got a shit ton of experience. Took a long time. I needed a bunch of movement speed. It already had the stamina, so that was alright. Because I figured I'm gonna use this one to move. I've already started building the new place. And then I found one of these in Purple Drop. So it's pretty much just pumping oil. I haven't it's the first time I tried this, as you all know. In case you don't know where to put these, just need to check the surroundings. Okay. In case you don't know where to put these, there are 16 different locations with all in all 22 veins, I think, oil veins. I had to look this up because I simply had no idea where to find them. I actually flew around for quite some time on the Argent, never found them. I tamed the Argent all the way over here on this is a small mountain here, and there was like two or three Argents. Had some trouble with the rock golem as well, trying to chase me down. But we'll get to one of those soon, I guess. The locations are at these three mountains out here, the oil vein locations. This is where I put one of them on, the oil pump. It's pretty much just, you just place it down once you got it. This is how an oil vein looks like. So it's pretty much a rock with oil coming out of it. And as I said, there are 22 of these in the map at 16 different locations, which means that some locations there are two right next to each other, like this one. So that's pretty much it about the oil veins. They pump one oil every 20 seconds, I think. I read a bunch about it because I figured that I might as well, now when I checked, might as well read how it goes, how to get this. So they look pretty good. It's a little bit weird that they're not running on electricity though, in my opinion. I don't know, maybe it's just me. I don't even know how they work in real life, so there's probably some clever mechanic someone can teach me about. Could look like an engine though. Anyways, for today, I have still been gathering a ton of stuff. I just brought the first foundations to the new location, which I'm going to show you. As you can see, I gave this quite a bit of movement speed. There's also an oil vein right there. That's probably the closest one to the house. The house is right down there by the water. Just didn't know about it, so yeah. But I have created or crafted a bunch of walls, and I only made 10 foundations, which I brought over there. But I need a ton more. This is also pretty good because it got 650 weight, so I actually have the chance of... Why is Tatiana roaming? Oh! I thought... Shit. I thought that was Tammy. Of course Tatiana's roaming. Just gonna get these. I've done this quite a lot yesterday. I think I gathered like, I don't know, maybe 10,000 sand. And I just put it in here and I created so much clay. I even have a lot more to spend. But still the wood is the problem pretty much. And I put it all over here. So I made a dinosaur gateway and 39 walls, and then I made 10 foundations so far. And I already placed the foundations. So we just need a bunch of wood, actually. There's nothing new to the house, pretty much. Got the same dinos, except the Argent here. which I'm pretty happy about because it's really helping about the traveling. Yeah, so that mountain over here is pretty much where it tamed the sergeant. It was only level 45 or something when I got it, and then it gained the extra levels of being tamed, so it might have been 60 something, maybe just under 70, and I gave it 44 levels just by really grinding and grinding and grinding, killing stuff, found some high level T-Rexes and stuff like that, got them in a nice position, shot them low with the crossbow, and then pretty much just killed it with the Argent. That's a pretty efficient way to level low level dinos that is not really the best at killing things. So yeah, that's the mountain. I tamed the Argent, and right now I am on my way to the location. I'm gonna show you what we're gonna build, because I want to be more centered to the map, and I figured over here would be nice also, because it seems like there is more trees, which I need. Oh, I also found this canteen, by the way, in a beam in one of the drops. Don't remember what color it was, but yeah, right here it is. This is where I'm gonna build my desert compound. Doesn't look like much right now, but I'm building here because of the water vein. So the plan is to make a lot of foundations and then place them around here in one big square. I will make walls around it, and I will make different buildings as well, something like that. And now it's apparently really hot, so also the reason I got so much movement speed on this guy pretty much is because I read no, I actually didn't read it, I saw it in a video. A guy talking about that if you have more than 185 movement speed, I think 185 is the same movement speed as the Wyverns, the dragon's wyvern. So I should pretty much be able to escape from one if I were to encounter one. I actually saw one while I was looking for oil veins close to the oil pump thing that I have. I saw one out there. So that was pretty interesting. It was a lightning one. Let's see. Oh, saddle for moth. I would like a better moth though, but they're really bad. Oh, there's audience up here as well. They are flying around this area. And yeah, out there is the Scorch. Not a place I want to go. Oh, so apparently this up here is a good place to get audience. There's a lot of these beams. What does this mean? This ring. Ooh, that was nice. That was very nice. Shouldn't this be a place full of metal, maybe? I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Ooh, so fast. Maybe we can even see a rock golem while we're up here. I think they spawn around mountains. What's that? Oh, that's one of those new ones that I never got to see in the normal one. The one that can actually... Whoa! Oh, shit. Okay, we're good. We're good. Safe range level. Can't see it too far away. Okay. So yeah, we're gonna build down here. gonna make a nice compound, and we are pretty centered. We have a bunch of trees, we have water, there's even, wait, this is not, over there is the place, but there's water down there, if, holy shit, it's hot right now, water down there, and we have these water veins. I'm gonna put a well on this one, and I think it's a nice place, to be honest. I think it's gonna work. Oh, there's another purple drop coming down. I just got journeyman. Ramshackle and relatives. Interesting. I haven't done much of this drop hunting. But what color is that? Is that a yellow? That's a yellow one. Totally going for that one. But yeah, I have been exploring a little bit with this. Wait, did you just say something? Tim, did you say something? I think he said something. Shit's about to go down. What? Waterfall? There's an actual waterfall. No. God damn it. What is going on here? Where's this water coming from? Okay, pretty much nowhere then. Alright. Okay, let's go back to the purple one over here then. If that's how it's supposed to be. And rock golems are actually not that hard to find. It was a high level one I found as well. Level 76. So it was like pretty decent level. But apparently they are only hiding like these red rocks, desert rocks, whatever, and they are sometimes hiding on these black mountains, so it's pretty obvious. I don't know what this ring means, but I have a feeling that it's good, that it says that there's maybe some good loot inside. Nah, don't want any of these, I found them already. I should get a Procoptodon as well. That's the kangaroo. In case you don't know the names. This heat thing is really, really annoying. I should probably get back home. So I can do stuff. Just give me a second, guys. I'm just gonna fly back instead of just flying around and talking all day. Alright, guys, we're back at the house. I'm afraid that I just died. Because I'm big. What's this? Oh, that's a saddle for the. Okay. Rock golem saddle as well. Yeah. I learned some stuff. Have to make new armor. Why? I need pearls. I died. I went AFK. And I came back. And I was dead. Very clever. And I don't remember where I was, so it's just even better. Now I'm just gonna get this back. And I actually thought about something, because it's gonna take some time to build this whole... it's gonna take some time to build this whole new place. I need more height. Why the fuck do I need hide all the time? Do we have hide on you? No hide, are you kidding me? Shit. Alright, thorny dragon. Let's go. I was actually thinking about seeing if I could get a wyvern egg. Just for the fun of it. I mean, I need one at some point anyways, so why not get one now? The only problem is I have no place to store it as of now, but I guess I could just go get some metal, get a refrigerator running, maybe a windmill. I could try one of the windmills as well. And then we should all be fine. So I think that's the plan right now. I just need some hide. That's what I got. 22 hide. Okay, and that one gave 106. That totally makes sense. Okay, Tim, you're gonna come egg hunting. As I understood, you pretty much need to boom. I can make a whip. Range it. Metal, of course. It's a big problem. What about spyglass? Spyglass. Crystal. Two crystal. I have some crystal. Crystal, thatch, fiber, wood. I don't know. What? Hide as well. Cool. Okay. I'm just gonna make some food and then I will be on my way. So 1 second, fellas. Alright guys, we made it to the Scorch. At the edge of it, figured we might as well start from one end to another. The plan is to locate an egg, fly down as fast as I can, grab it and get the hell out. But I don't feel like just going down there. Like, damn. As far as I'm concerned, or at least what I know, they should be in those small holes in the wall, like this one. Wait a second. I think I just saw something. I see one. There is one right there in front of me. There's a fire dragon. It's a fire egg, isn't it? It's gonna be impossible to get if that guy's gonna fly around in there. That's for sure. Damn. Okay, gonna see if we can find anything else then. Just gonna keep that in mind. It's probably not gonna go anywhere. Level 116. I think I heard about these Vivens being able to actually be 140. So they would come off as the like complete superior dino or animal thing. Alright. Do we have any? There's another one. Right down there. All by itself, though. Question is, am I gonna be able to do this? I'm gonna try. Gonna fuck it. Going down super fast. Going down super fast. Super fast. Landing. Stopping. Grabbing egg. Okay. We're off. Oh, damn. Oh, damn. Totally being chased by a dragon. Yes, I'm faster. I read correctly. I totally read it correctly. Got my first egg. Okay, so I should be able to see parents' levels. Holy shit! Holy fucking shit! It's a max level fire dragon wyvern. Oh shit! Oh shit, I'm dead, I'm fucking dead. Oh no, that was really sad. Fuck. I spent so long time fucking getting that art ending level. Jesus Christ. Ah, that hurt in my soul, guys. Fuck. Oh, shit. I'm gonna go get a new Argent. Back at square one, I just found the perfect egg and I died. Shit. At least I know where I died. I'll see if I can go get it back. Be very, very, very lucky. Gonna use the moth though. Fucking hell. One second.